Breeder's Crown, two-year-old filly trots, sponsored by Ainsworth. Field 10. Mid-stretch. Here they come. And they're off, and trotting SMS Princess and Svanstead stepping right out quickly, grabbing the lead from the outside, challenging early as they step out past the stands. It's Lily Stride, and moving up between horses there, it's Fate Tosev and Manchego as they trot three deep into the first turn. Racing over to the quarter mile marker, and Manchego on the inside has the advantage here on Fate Tosev, but they're too wide past the quarter in 27-2. SMS Princess, meantime, takes back to third. A gap of two lengths fourth to Atlanta. Another two fifth on the outside. It's Tough Expectations. They're alongside Hey Blondie. Moving to the outside comes Jordan Blue Chip as they head down the backstretch. Then it's looking for Zelda, and Seviorum is last in 10th. Now approaching the half, and Fate Tosev has won the early skirmish here. Manchego there in the inside, follows along in second. SMS Princess right there with the hunt in third. 55-4 was the halftime, and Fetosov and Schmitzhammer leading the way to the upper turn. Manchego to the inside, waiting in second. SMS Princess trots in third. And here comes Lily Stride. Tim Tietrich on his way with her. Just off her back is Top Expectations. She's second over fifth. Atlanta Berry to the inside. Jordan Blue Chip to the outer flow. Locked and shuffled, Hey Blondie. They come to the top of the stretch, and with the lead, it's Fetosa. But off her back now comes Manchego, and the battle begins at three quarters at 126-2. Fetosa by the inside, Manchego going right at the leader. Manchego puts a nose in front. Manchego clears a length. Fetosa back on the inside, trotting in second. SMS Princess out of the outside, a heart charging Seviorum. But as they come to the wire, it's Manchego, and Manchego will go undefeated. She's 12-for-12. Manchego wins the Breeders' Crown and won 54-4. Unofficial winner, the four, Manchego. Second, the nine, that's Seviorum. Third, number five, Fetosov. And fourth, the one, Atlanta. 4-9-5-1 unofficial. The eighth race is official. Eighth race trophy presentation sponsored by the Victory Hill Farms of LaGrange, Indiana. Manchego returning $3, 210, 210. Into the Victory Hill Farms winner's circle, ladies and gentlemen, introducing the 2017 Breeders' Crown Champion for two-year-old filly trotters, sponsored by Ainsworth, Manchego. As the filly goes 12 for 12, remaining undefeated. A daughter of Muscle Hill out of Secret Magic by Cantab Hall, a $120,000 yearling purchase by Black Horse Racing, John Fielding and Herb Leverman. Jimmy Tactor trains, Yannick Gingras drives. Trotting the mile this evening in 1 minute 54, 4/5. Caretaker for the champion Manchego, Alan Lopez. The 4-9 exacta, $75.20. Trifecta, $186.40. Superfecta, $1,031.80. So the winner's circle, Ron Ratcliffe and Jim Brown of Centaur Racing.
Well, undefeated is one thing. A superstar is another. Manchego takes the two-year-old filly trot. A 31st Breeders' Crown win for Jimmy Tactor. Jimmy, congratulations on that feat. But you talked about this horse, how special you thought she was. You've won this category four out of the last five years. How does she rate up with the others?
Well, that's one thing I don't want to do. I don't want to rate horses. I mean, you know, it's not fair to the other champions we had, but, you know, she's unique. I mean, do what she had done, you know, all year. I mean, 12 straight wins, that's tough to do in today's market. I mean, it's a really so hard for a horse to stay in shape for a season. But she's just a unique animal, and I am so proud to be part of her.
And it's a record because it's never been done before in this category. Let's talk about the race itself. It looked like they were taking it to you. Did the race set up the way you thought it would?
Exactly. I mean, I have a lot of respect for Transfilly. She's been chasing us all year. I mean, I know she's a very, very good filly, and I didn't want her in my back. Yannick and I spoke about it a little bit. You know, I'd rather sit behind her and let her do a little dirty job. And the race couldn't fold up better for me. I mean, we had to stretch him a little bit to the half. And, you know, when I saw that half, I say she's going to win this.
Jimmy, thank you so much for the time. We know you have more races coming up.
I was going to take the opportunity and say congratulations to the partners in this horse, John Fielding and Herb Lieberman, that is not here tonight. Congratulations, guys.
Thank you, Jimmy. Let's talk to Barry Gariglia. He's here tonight. You were grinning from ear to ear. What was going through your mind as they were going around the turn?
Kind of like Jimmy said, the race kind of unfolded the way I thought. I figured Tron would leave with a trailer in there. Yannick did a great job. He just kind of left let him go, sat his back, and she was loaded as usual.
You know, whether they're standardbreds or thoroughbreds, to see a two-year-old like this accomplish what she has accomplished, at what point did you see her as she was developing early and think, this one might be special?
It kind of took a couple of starts. I mean, I've been doing this a long time. I've had some nice horses and nothing, anything like this. Probably after the Mary Annabelle, I realized this is a special horse. And she just has an attitude that is unparalleled.
Yeah.
She just wants to do it and kind of has a spring in her step, and she always brings it.
And one other thing. Historically speaking, first time in the history of the Breeders' Crown right here at Hoosier Park. How special is that for you?
It was absolutely super. I mean, I turned on the computer the other day and I saw the story, and I text Jimmy, had you seen the Manchego story? And because I had no idea, but it just made it a little extra special.
All right, Barry, you and your partners obviously couldn't be here. Thank you so much. Enjoy the moment, and we expect to see you here a lot more.
Appreciate it. Great job you guys did. Thank you.
Thank you.